Hi, Jaka. Thank you to be a guest at our EPI Congress and for taking the time to chat with us about your career and personal and professional experiences. You've been an elite player in many EuroLeague teams, playing EuroLeague for your national team as well. First question, I'm going straight to the point. Which has been your secret to be competitive and successful for so many seasons, if you have one?
Yeah. First of all, hi, Francesco, and everybody. Thank you for having me. It's an honor to share my experiences here with ELPA and everybody, which I think is important. So for the first question, actually, I feel that my inner me, desire, dedication, and always being physically ready helped me during my career to be always prepared, always ready, and I think this was a big help in my career. Of course, there was ups and downs, but in general speaking, like dedication, my mentality was for sure the key.
So being competitive also when you was a child, you was a competitive child from day first?
Yes, I was very competitive. I was a very competitive guy on and off the court. There was no game I would take it easy, but you know that kept me going. That kept me always on my toes, always ready to improve, always looking for that extra step in my game, in game of my team, and of course in my career.
But probably you are agree with me. Player's life isn't easy always. You know, many days far from home. Family, you got many travels, different hotels, many practices, games, injuries, wins and losses, media. And now, you know, for the current players, you know, a lot of social media, social communication to face with. So how you've been able to keep your level of commitment at the highest level? Because, okay, passion is important, being competitive is important, but you got to make some day-by-day job, you know? It's just a passion, is a challenge with yourself, both. I don't know, which was your approach on it?
Well, yes, I totally agree. Professional career of a professional athlete, not only basketball here, I mean, everything is very difficult. Many days away from home, hotels, like you said, ups and downs, where actually downs are pretty tough. So, you know, being for myself, you know, was being able to get up every morning and look for that excellence, I would say, because I would not use the word perfection, because perfection, in my opinion, perfection doesn't exist. Excellence is totally different meaning. Excellence, you look to be your best self every day. And if you have the mentality, the will, the commitment to look for that excellence every day, you have numbers, big numbers to be successful in what you do. So I believe, you know, getting up every day and making the most of it was very important for me. Here, of course, like you said, outside factors as a press, a lot of pressure on players, on teams to be successful. Now we are seeing different kind of factors like social media. Agents are involved more and more with already young kids. So those are all the outside factor that can affect a player development, a player mentality, or the right mindset. So it's not easy. It's getting harder day by day. But you know, we as ex players or now coaches, we want to and we try to not only coach the player also outside the court to learn, you know, know-how and you know, the right mentality to go to the desired destination. You know?
Great. Have you had some mentors in your career, not just basketball players, but I mean, positive examples to follow?
For sure. I was fortunate enough that I was part of a big organization throughout my career. And for sure, I had a lot of positive influence as well coaches and as well as players. I played with some of the greats for sure. I would mention here for sure just a couple of them. You know, here my first really influence was Daryl Middleton, who was a great professional in basketball. He taught me a lot, not only with the words but with the actions on the court, off the court, how he took care of his body, professionalism, and you know, just being the right, the best guy, the best teammate possible every day. And for him, here I would mention his name. For sure, I would mention here as well Francesco Salvertis, who was a great captain of Panathinaikos for forever.
Yeah,
he's still one of the greats. And of course, coaches, you know, Jelko Bradovic was a big time influence on me. This was my first year coming out of Slovenia. And, you know, he really, I would say, taught me a lot, mentored me as a player, of course, but then also not only for basketball, also for life itself.
Great. Great example. You know, we're mentioning, you know, great person, great players, you know. And I'm absolutely agree that sometimes we need some examples, live examples on our life. Recently, I've heard a podcast with my former player in NBA, Jose Calderon, and recently retired, and saying that when playing basketball wasn't a priority anymore, it was time for him to move on. You know, when you did realize that your time to move on had arrived.
Yeah, I mean, I would for sure agree with Jose on that one. When you see that basketball is not the priority to you anymore, then most probably you won't be able to commit 100% 100% every day. So in that case, it's time to call it quits. For me, it was not exactly like this because, like I said, my mentality was, you know, like that basketball was a priority for me every day, every second. So for me, it was a little bit more like when I felt that my body cannot be at the top of its of the best shape possible, that I had to take care of more of my body than my basketball, then it was a little bit of a sign, okay, you gotta think what you want to do, and because it's not easy after, you know, it's not easy that you are more worried about your body than about what you love to do, you know.
Yeah. Now you're coaching, and which is the most difficult thing that you have found in this new professional challenge? You know, from playing to coaching, I think it's a big jump.
Yes, I mean, the challenge was for sure first at the beginning was for sure that you have to forget that you are not a player anymore. This is first thing for sure, because yes, it's the same sport, but it's totally different job. this was for sure one of the first challenges I faced. But as well, what I'm facing now in my second or third year is, you know, how to psychology part of the team, you know, how to manage players, how to manage a group, because it's never black and white. You have 12 individuals in the locker room. Somebody is white, but somebody is blue or yellow. So everybody reacts to different, or on the same thing, they react differently. So you have to know them, you have to understand them, and then you have to manage the situation at hand at every time for each individual, and trying to put this together to make good pasta. You know, and this is, I think, the mental part or psychology part of the job, and especially in these days, is very, very important. And for me, is a challenge. I'm still learning, but I think, you know, we are going in the right direction.
Great, great. You was mentioning before that you have had many, many coaches, and I think any coach has his own way of coaching, you know, different style, different yes. culture. Some coaches are just taking care about X and O's. Other coaches are jumping all over the places. So lifestyle, treatments, management. I mean, they like to touch any single component of the organization, for example. So is there one thing that when you did start coaching, compared with your player experience, you had in mind to do differently or to repeat in the same way?
I mean, yes, I've been, like I said before, I've been really fortunate to work with a lot of great coaches in my career, and learned a lot from them. And, you know, I know the basketball part, how they try to do, but as well as some of the things they try to do, maybe managing the team outside the court in different stressful situation, how to do this. So I'm really taking what I thought was the best from those coaches, and
cherry picking the best things from all of them.
The best things, in my opinion, from all of them, of course. And the one thing I always learned, you know, just especially here, I would mention for sure Coach Obradovic. He was always having the same demands, or same with everybody. He was the same, yeah. Same attention to everybody. You know, nobody was high, nobody was low. Yes, everyone has its role in the team, but everybody has the same importance. So this was the thing that I loved about him. Yeah. And I try to keep it also in my process of coaching the same way. Everybody, all the players, I think they have to feel that they are important, but for sure they have to know that the roles might are different.
You know what? I worked 2 years with Zeliko, and from my personal experience, he was probably the only coach that he was coaching a stressful situation. You know, how to manage pressure. So basketball is a logic, is tactics, is whatever. But you know, when you gotta call the play to win a game, you gotta call the system, you gotta, you know, apply the system for that topic moment of the game, is always question how you manage emotional stress.
Yes.
And Zeliko is the one that, you know, he knows how to help you to manage situation. He can jump on you, he can provoke you, but at the end of the season, I've seen so many players, completely different, like habit, culture, American players, former Yugoslavia, European, whatever, at the end of the season, they appreciate the job done with Zeliko. It means he got a great, great system. And results. I mean,
exactly. I totally agree on this. Totally agree. Because a lot of people, they see Coach Bradovic on the side having almost limit of the fight with the his players at all times. In the end of the day, you see the players that they would do everything on the court for Jelko. So that that emotional connection is something special. That how he handled this, and it's a really, really special thing that he's able to do.
Yeah, I agree. Absolutely. So let's move a little bit on another topic. You know, what did you study the most to become a coach? So when you decide, to change your professional life from being a professional player to a coach, if you found some topics, fields were necessary for you to make an educational process, let's say.
Well, it's very interesting because as a young player, like I told you, I was very competitive. And because of this competitiveness, I was also, emotionally not very, I was more emotionally up and down because of that. And I could say I was some kind of rebel, so already when I was, start going to university in Ljubljana for sports. I met this professor of sports psychology, and we had this subject. And then I already playing for Slovan Ljubljana. I started working with him on focusing. Having sessions one time per week, and. Really, this helped me recognize the importance of emotional well-being or emotional stability in sports, in professional sports especially. So what I studied for sure here, I would mention the University of Ljubljana Faculty for Sports, which I finished. But for me, the most interesting, and also especially in this time where we have 80 games per season, especially looking at EuroLeague, where is not a lot of time to work, to practice. So emotional stability, and of course, together with physical readiness is the key. And I think in this department in Europe, I think in basketball especially, we still have big steps to cover, and I think this is one very interesting thing that I would like to study even a little bit further to help my players and my team in that department, which is not only X and O's, like we said before,
Yeah. No, I think, just a making some thoughts about my professional experience. I remember at the beginning, I was taking care about strength conditioning, about exercises on the floor. To be honest, in the last 20 years, we are taking care about the lifestyle, for example, or monitoring training load. There were some fields of interest that nowadays are becoming more popular than in the past. So same logic, for you, like a professional coach, how do you see the future of being a professional? Which kind of topics, fields, in your opinion, are changing in the last period?
Yeah, I mean, I would, in this case, I would totally connect with your thoughts on the, having the lifestyle under control, which helps a lot in recovery. Like I said, emotional well-being, and together with physical preparation and controlling the load. I was last 2 years. I was part of coaching teams in NBA in the summer league. I talked a lot also to those specialists who was employed for this controlling the load. And they explained to me, you know, difference between a two-a-day practice than one-a-day practice where you can go a little bit longer, but you know how to take care of the body from the get-go, from the preseason on. And there is a lot of things that I think in Europe we can still learn and you know get better at. And me as a coach, I want to really listen to those experts and learn, because in the end of the day, you need your players healthy when it mattered the most. And it's now the playoffs after the stressful nine-month season where the situation is like this, that players are almost today imprisoned in home because of the pandemic situation. So like emotional stress on the players is huge and affects the physical physical readiness as well. So I think those are the things that we have to take in account every day, much and much more and more to have our teams ready, because the games are just building up. There are 60 to 80 game seasons, so it's not easy.
Absolutely. This is the reason why, like ELPA, we have created this performance advisory board. So it's a multidisciplinary group of people, experts. All of them, all of us are, you know, with this great scientific background. So we have a strength conditioning, but we have a nutrition, we have a sport psychology, we have traumatology, so injury prevention. We have a sport scientist, so data scientist. So group of people that share, you know, information and knowledge for players' performance. So it's not just one topic. The performance of being a professional player, it's, you know, a multidisciplinary approach, and not any organization can have, you know, specialists, you know, for these crossing experiences. So this is why we are trying to build up this group, sharing knowledge like we are doing in our Congress. And, you know, and I'm sure that in the future, this kind of mentality will be spread all over the basketball community. So to move forward, you know, also, I mean, to end our discussion, have you some tips, some, let's say, take care, take home messages for our listeners? We have a lot of players that are, you know, attending our EPIC Congress that dream in their post-career to become a professional coach. So if there are some tips that you want to share with them.
Yes, I mean, I would firstly say you are a player, that's great. You want to become coach, even better, to spread your, you know, teach your youngsters your experience, to help them. But the first tip is, if you think you know everything, you are really wrong. So it's two different jobs. So the tip is be curious, study more, learn more, ask more, because once you get on this chair, then you have to have the answers. Of course, you will never have all the answers, but I would like to say one thought that Coach Obradovic always said, you have to be every day ready to have all the answer what the players might ask. So may that be a stupid question, could be, but be ready to have all the answers, and then you will be successful. So be ready, be prepared, and don't rely on your player career to be your leader in coach's career. So take the knowledge you have as a player, but study more to be better coach.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you. You know, it's amazing what you say. In the meantime, I was talking about your experience. I was thinking about some of my players that now are coaching. And like you say, all of them, they were very curious. You know, players that are only asking you, you know, players that only try to steal from everybody. Why this? Why that? Why not tomorrow? Why not today? Why not? Why so heavy? Why so light? Why we're not this? You know, they were always discussing. And, you know, I got a few of examples that now they are coaching top teams in different leagues. And they were curious. So I'm absolutely agree with you. Don't stop asking. You can be agree or not. Like you say, coaching probably is a job of compromises. You know, there's never white and black. There are a lot of different colors, a scale of gray in between. And it's normal to make mistakes. Okay, so it's normal sometimes to fail. You gotta learn. So the idea, failing is a process. So you gotta try to avoid, you know, on failing from what you're doing. But, you know, learning, being humble, sharing choices, because you are not perfect, like you say. You can have a better experience or less experience and work on yourself. Because working on yourself means taking care about your own performance. Now you are coach, and you're still taking care about your performance. Because if you wanna be a better coach, you are still working on yourself. So thank you, you know, exactly, for anything you say, because it was amazing. And it was a very, very, very clear, detailed and a clear explanation. So I think very helpful and understandable for all our listeners, I guess. So Jaka, I wish you all the best for your life and career. And I will send you all the questions that I receive from our listeners, so you can potentially answer them. So once again, you know, I hope we can meet in a basketball court live. It means that this outbreak has finished finally, and we can still take care about life, about our life and our passion like before. So thank you again, and once again, all the best.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Francesco. Thank you for having me, and thank you also from your guiding me through this interview. Of course, with your knowledge, you know, it's very easy to guide me. So thank you very much, and I hope this interview will help you know, future coaches and anybody who identifies with the interview.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye bye.